So I'm at community services, a week and a half after I asked them to give me a different worker, because my worker is sabotaging my life. He's making sure that he conspires and talks behind my back, and he's made it so I cannot get my wheelchair serviced anywhere. Anyway, there's a bunch of conspirators in this so-called government, because they're all a bunch of crooks, and they don't like me because my websites are up and running, and the evidence, what they've been doing to me and other things going on this planet are all on my websites, which is truthsoldier.com, canadiansituations.wordpress.com, chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com, and many other websites that I have. So here I am at community services. I'm about to go in there and ask them why they haven't called me and haven't signed a new worker for me like I requested a week and a half ago. I'm going to put the cap on my camera because I don't need to get anyone's faces on this video. Number 20. I guess I'm next. Does that mean you called 20? Which window?
Come to me.
Hello.
Hi.
I came here about a week and a half ago. Oh, and by the way, just so you know, last time I didn't do it, but I'm recording this conversation. And I came here a week and a half ago, and I asked that my worker be replaced, because what he's doing is pretty criminal, and he's never returned a call of mine in more than 2 years, and the supervisors don't call me either. And you know, when somebody's bad in the government, they just lie to everybody they work with and continue their story, write stuff, and you know, make phone calls, and that's what he's been doing to my life. So I requested that I get a different worker, because right now what he's done, he's sabotaged the ability for me to get my wheelchair serviced anywhere. Anywhere. Wendy Anderson, Minister of Health Assistant, has been aware of this for 2.5 years, what's been going on. I've documented everything. It's all with videos on my website. And it's been going on for quite a while, people sabotaging my wheelchair to do me serious harm. And there's no lack of proof of it, okay? I called the police, they've got a file on it. I want to file charges, and they've got the evidence. It's all done. My work is all done. And all I've requested a week and a half ago is that I get a different worker. And you guys haven't called me, and I need another worker, because I have to get arrangements made to fix my wheelchair. Without my wheelchair, I don't have a life. I live on my own. Hi.
Excuse me, sir. Can I have your name, please?
Daniel Towsey. Okay, so you're gonna resolve this problem today, because I came here a week and a half ago and no one called me, and I asked for a new worker. You know, maybe you guys should have asked me, why do I want a new worker? What's going on? But you never even bothered asking me what's going on. Okay.
If you wouldn't mind just going over.
Well, I don't mind going over there as long as you tell me why I'm going over there, because my number came up.
I am familiar with your name.
Right. So what are you gonna do for me?
And I'm just gonna discuss it with the supervisor. Who's your caseworker?
Glenn Moore.
Okay.
Yeah,
he's
not going to be my worker anymore, because I'll never talk to him again. Because the last two times I've seen him, he got me yelling at him. I was on the phone talking to him, and he's nothing but a bunch of lies coming out of his mouth.
I'm going to look into your presence.
It's really bad.
And if you can just go over there.
Well, I'm recording this, just so you know, I told her, I'm recording this conversation, okay? Because I'm going to have the evidence that I came in here and I asked you to rectify this problem with your worker lying to the Minister of Health's assistant about my condition and in my wheelchair and what's been going on. You outright lied to everybody.
Okay, I'm not familiar.
Right.
With
Anyway, I'm going to keep my camera on. I'm going to record all this, because I don't care if you resolve it or not, because when I leave here, I have a whole bunch of things to do today, because I can't go out in bad weather. And I've been at the legislature. I've talked to the people in charge. They all know who I am. They all know my case. It's everything that I'm telling you is all well documented on the website. The manufacturer of this chair in Ontario is aware of what's been done to it.
There's trouble.
They sent people in from the Netherlands, where this chair comes from, to talk to the head office in Ontario. I bought my wheelchair, and they're very, very concerned that my chair has been sabotaged.
You know what?
Yeah, well, my life is public, and any area that I'm sitting is where I'm going to talk. Okay, so if you don't want people to hear this stuff, then you people shouldn't be doing this stuff to me. Anyway, Glenn Moore, he's going to be in a lot of trouble really soon, because the police have the file on all of this, okay?
I'm going to look up your circumstances.
Well, I'm going to keep recording the call today after this. I'm leaving. I'm going to a few other politicians' places that are waiting for me. And it's going to blow up in your faces, because I'm going to make sure that the media has already done a 45-minute interview with me. Everybody's got all the information. And Glenn Moore is the cause of all my nightmare. Him talking to people behind my back at the places that repair and service wheelchairs, making it sound like I'm a lunatic and all kinds of other things, and constantly undermining my life so that people start treating me like garbage. And when I speak up and I say, why are you doing this? And remember, Wendy Anderson is the Minister of Health Assistant. 2.5 years she's been keeping records of all the events. Okay, she's got all the events. You people here should be managing your business better, because when I was here last time, Glenn Moore, when I was here last time over a year ago, and I left here screaming because he is so abusive, did you guys ever call me and show any concern and ask me what happened? No, you didn't, because you don't care. Okay?
Again, Mr. Townsend.
I'm going to go sit over there, and I will wait. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Seven minutes. Time to turn off my camera and turn it back on when this nightmare continues.